21 Signs You Are an Advanced Soul.
This is Law of Attraction Secrets. Join miracle mentor and alchemy life coach Robert Zink and prepare to be empowered.
Hello, everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Whatever time you're listening to this special Law of Attraction podcast, I am your miracle mentor, your mentor of light, Robert Zink. And today, we are soaring high like a big, beautiful eagle flying in the direction of your dreams and your goals. We're getting all excited again because November 11th, 11/11 is coming. It's approaching quickly, 2018. And we are inviting between 2 and 4 people to our home to spend 3 days in an incredible intensive energy retreat. And we're going to spend the last day in Sedona in the vortex. So you come in on Friday, you fly out on Monday, which is a holiday, and it's going to be one of the most incredible experiences that you've ever gone through. Transformational beyond belief. Look at, if you've been focusing on manifesting a relationship, money, business, this is the weekend for you. And we're only having 2 to 4 people here, so it's up to you. The first come, first serve. But you must send me an email, your CV or resume, a picture of yourself, and we'll go from there. Okay, 21 signs you are an advanced soul. Now, an advanced soul, or oftentimes called an old soul, these are people that just manifest easy. I mean, they just make it happen. For some reason, others struggle, but these people seem to know how to manifest easily. They have a mission and purpose in life, so they're not looking to manifest anything and everything. They are focused on their mission and purpose, and many of them seem to know their mission and purpose at 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 years of age. I mean, it's incredible. You go back and, oh, I've always known I wanted to do this. I've always known this was my path. This is the kind of stuff you hear from an advanced soul. They are empowered individuals. They have incredible power, and they have a high capacity for love. I mean, they just love nonstop without end. They are filled with incredible amounts of love, not just for human beings, but for themselves, for their family, for the world in which they live. Are you ready? Let's go through this 21 list. But first, let's take a deep breath in through the nose. Hold it and out through the mouth. Oh, that feels good. Yes. Number one, they have clear, clean, intense, powerful eyes. They have eyes that just denote wisdom. You look at their eyes and you go, there's something back there that is beyond what I see in most people. They're just an intensity with their eyes. Their eyes have the ability to pierce right through you. Their presence, number two, their presence is healing. Just having these people around, if you don't feel well, you want an old soul or an advanced soul person around you because just their presence is healing. And you find that with many nurses that are advanced souls. They walk into, there can be 100 nurses, but that one nurse walks into your room and you just start to feel better. Number three, they're non-judgmental. And now they have their own beliefs. They have their own goals and dreams and they're focused, but they're not going to judge you on your dreams. They're never going to judge you on your goals. They are open to that. And they're just non-judgmental people. They accept things the way they are. Number four, they value life in all forms. They value old people. They value young people. They value sick people. They value animals. They value plants. They value life in all forms. You will never be able to convince an advanced soul that taking a life serves a purpose other than in extreme cases of self-defense.
This is the number one podcast on personal empowerment, success, and the law of attraction. You're listening to the Miracle Mentor of Light, Robert Zink.
Number five, advanced souls are incredibly intuitive. They have a pineal gland that is completely open, and it is, their intuitive ability to understand what is going on in the world, what is going on in your life, what is happening. I'm not saying that they're psychic, because the word psychic, it just has a bad connotation today. But they are intuitive. They're in tune with the vibrations. And it's because they have an open pineal gland. Number six, they are strong in their convictions. They have spiritual beliefs, and you will not be able to talk them out of it. Now, they won't try to talk you into their beliefs. That's the difference. They will listen, they will nod, and they will move on. They will simply keep their strong spiritual beliefs. These are beliefs oftentimes that they have chosen, that they have said, this is my belief, this is what I choose. And they understand there are different beliefs out there, but they've gone through a number of experiences, and this is what they choose. Number seven, these advanced souls have an incredible hunger and thirst for the ancient mysteries. They love studying the Eleusinian mysteries, the Greek mysteries, the mysteries of ancient Egypt. They are hungry to understand what the ancients believed and what they taught. And then they are very quick to incorporate some of that teaching into their present-day life. Number eight, they have strong and powerful auras. But when you're around one of these advanced souls, you just feel tranquil. You just feel good. They have tranquility emanating from their soul. Number nine, advanced souls speak the truth. They don't lie. Truth is very important to them, and they understand that it's their truth. So when you're around an advanced soul, don't expect to receive a lot of BS. They're going to give you the truth the way they see it. Number 10, they have a deep passion for source, for God, for light, for spirit. They hunger for this connection, and they are constantly nurturing and working on their connection to be closer to God, to be closer to spirit. Number 11, they understand the oneness that exists throughout the entire universe, that really there is only one, that there is only one source and one emanation, and we are part of that emanation, we are part of that source. They don't see divisions. They don't live in duality. They live in unity. Number 12, they love music and writing and art, anything that helps express the soul, pottery, statue making, whatever. If it expresses the soul, they absolutely love it. Number 13, they live in non-duality. As I said, in the ancient temples, there were two major pillars in Solomon's temple. There was a pillar of Yakin and Boaz. And they stand right in the center of Yakin and Boaz. They stand in between the two pillars, one hand on each, and they are connected to both. Number 14, these are the people, these advanced souls are the people that give out money, they're generous, and they never ask for it back. If you say to an advanced soul, can I borrow $500? They'll likely give you the $500, but they'll say, this is a gift. I'm not asking for you to return it. And there's two reasons for that. if you ask somebody to return the money and they don't, then there's always this kind of barrier between the two of you. In other words, they don't come around because they feel guilty that they haven't repaid you. So what's really important is to just give the money and not expect anything in return. And that's exactly what advanced souls do. Number 15, they see numbers like 1111 all the time. I mean, some of us see it, you know, every now and then, every few days we might see 1111. They're seeing it all the time. They're tuned in to that high vibration of 1111. Number 16, high advanced souls celebrate love in other people. When other people are celebrating their life, a life experience, a new job, a new car, a new home, a new relationship, they are celebrating. They are absolutely excited for you. Number 17, advanced souls have vivid dreams of ancient times. They seem to know that they were connected to ancient times and to maybe even as far back as Lemuria and Atlantis, and they have dreams of those times. Number 18, advanced souls are open to love and commitment. You see, they don't see love without commitment. Advanced souls believe that the two work hand in hand, that they are co-partners, so to speak, in the highest of human experiences. Number 19, advanced souls, they do tend to avoid drugs like even marijuana and alcohol, any of that kind of stuff. A matter of fact, I have met advanced souls that won't even take an aspirin or anything. They just refuse to put anything foreign in their body other than natural food, water, and air. Number 20, advanced souls are deeply attached to crystals. They love crystals for some reason. And you can tell children, you can put a bunch of toys and a few crystals on the floor and put some children in the room. And a lot of the children will go to the dump truck. Some will go to this, go to that. But there'll be that one child who just collects all the crystals. That's all he's interested in. And he's not playing with them. He's feeling them. He's connecting with them. And finally, number 21, advanced souls love growing things. They love gardening. They love growing herbs. They love to grow things. They love to see life express itself through growth. You know, some of the most advanced souls I have met were people that had little gardens, or if they lived in the city, they had little herb gardens. And I don't know, it's just something about it. It's just something about that growing process. They love to get dirt in their hands, so to speak. They love to get involved with the energy of life. Well, there you have it. 21 traits of an advanced soul or old soul. If you fit into about 4 or 5 of them, you are likely an advanced soul and may need special help and special nurturing. You need to be around people that are like you, people that are advanced souls as well. You need to learn how to use your powers and your energy. Oh, you've got a lot of good that you can do for a number of people in this world. We're out of time. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you for subscribing. And we will be back tomorrow with another one. Have a great day, because you absolutely deserve it, and keep soaring like a big, beautiful eagle.